I think the most important thing that's happened in philanthropy in the last 30 years is the economic maturing of the community.
I think the most important event of the last 30 years has been the coming together of philanthropists in Miami with a vision of what Miami should be instead of what it had been.
So I see the Miami of today, 30 years later, as almost 180 degrees removed from what it was just in 1985.
In the last 30 years, you've had Ted Arison creates the New World Symphony.
In 1986, Miami City Ballet was founded.
The culture that we know today, the art and the music and the symphonies and all that, they were at most just beginning at that time.
And Ted and Lynn Arison created the Young Arts Organization and at the same time the New World Symphony. And it also was one of the factors that caused people to start thinking we need a great performing arts center, which is where we're sitting today.
The thing that I'm most proud of participating in philanthropy in Miami is Give Miami Day.
In order to have a great city, you have to have a lot of contributors.
Philanthropists of all ages and sizes getting together for one sole purpose, and the sole purpose is to move Miami into the upper echelon of greatness.
All of these things would not have been possible in the economic situation of Miami 50 years ago.
And we had a great history of people coming down to really begin their life almost over again. And many of our philanthropists today came without a lot of means, but they were very successful in building businesses. They gave them the means and were very fortunate that they just didn't keep them, you know, close to their own chest, but that they have become very beneficent on giving it to the community.
30 years happened to be the 30th anniversary of the Bonaconi Fund to cure paralysis at the Miami Project, so it's very appropriate that you ask 30 years. But there are so many things, the University of Miami, this Miami Science Museum, Fairchild Tropical Gardens.
The thing that excites me most is the diversity of all the cultural opportunities that we have. The exhibits really engage people of all ages because we're a very diverse community.
Well, I remember 1995 where the United Way was responding to a desperate call for help to people who were coming across the Florida Straits.
Miami has become a much more sensitive place toward people in need.
And this United Way rallied volunteers, rallied dollars, brought together everything from the school system to local entertainers, and spent almost 2 years with those people teaching English, teaching civics, and really preparing them for life in Miami.
And also it's really uplifted a lot of elements of the city, from culture to giving.
That creates a base on which everybody can build.